मरेंद्रो उत्तम फलितालु साधिंचिन विद्या संस्थ NSR Impulse ఈ ఫలితాలు సాధించడానికి కారణమైన లెక్చరర్లు మరియు తల్లిదండ్రులకు మా కృతజ్ఞతలు. NSR Impulse Educational Institutions.
So, we discussed about closed organ pipes and open organ pipes, fundamental frequencies, harmonics, overtones and this. So, in case of in open pipes, all harmonics exist. In open pipe, all harmonics exist. So that means the ratio of harmonics is, let us say, V by 2L, 2V by 2L, so 3V by 2L, and so on like that. In closed pipe, only odd harmonics exist. So V by 4L, so 3V by 4L. So 5V by 4L and so on like this. So in case of open pipe, all harmonics exist. In case of closed pipe, only odd harmonics exist. Remaining all does not exist. So here we can do some applications based on these organ pipes. So let us say first condition is open pipe. Let us say open pipe of length L and its fundamental frequency is f. So now it is immersed in liquid such that half of length of pipe is above the liquid. Half of the length of the pipe is above the liquid. Then find the fundamental frequency of that. Fundamental frequency of that pipe. So that is the given question. So let us say it is the open pipe of length L. Its fundamental frequency can be written as V by 2L. We know that. Fundamental frequency of the open pipe is F is equals to V by 2L. Now, that pipe is immersed in liquid such that half of the length of the pipe is above the liquid. Only half of the length of the pipe. So, this is L by 2. Half of the length of the pipe is above the liquid. That means remaining half is in liquid. Remaining half is inside the liquid. Half is above the liquid, half is below the liquid. Now, what we have to do? Find the fundamental frequency of that pipe. We have to find out the fundamental frequency of this pipe. We have to calculate this one. So, this means above the liquid, the pipe has length L by 2 and it acts as closed pipe. Above the liquid, the pipe has a length of L by 2. And this one acts as a closed pipe because up to here it is closed. So this part up to here, the water exists, water or liquid, whatever it is, where we immerse this pipe, that medium exists here. So that means this remaining part acts as, the remaining part of the pipe acts as closed pipe. So now this part is closed pipe of length L by 2. So the part is closed pipe of length L by 2, closed pipe of length L by 2. So fundamental frequency of closed pipe is 4 V by 4 L dash. So F dash is equals to V by 4 into L dash. What is the length of this closed pipe? L by 2. So F dash is equals to V by 2 L. So F dash is equals to F. The frequency does not changes. If the half part of the pipe is immersed in liquid, what is the frequency of the remaining part? Fundamental frequency of the remaining part is same as that of the original open pipe. So F dash is equals to F. F dash is equals to F, like this. Now the same situation, so in the same situation, so let us say this is the open pipe of length L. Its fundamental frequency is V by 2 L, not worried about that. So for example, if 1/4 only the pipe is immersed in liquid, so that here the pipe is immersed in liquid, so that only 1/4 of the length is above the liquid. Only 1/4 of the length is above the liquid. Then what is the frequency here? So here this is the closed pipe, because up to here this is liquid. Above part acts as closed pipe. So here it is. Here the remaining part of pipe acts as closed pipe of length L by 4, closed pipe of length L by 4. So then closed pipe, fundamental frequency of closed pipe, V by 4 L dash. So V by 4 into L dash is L by 4. So F dash is equals to V by L. So from this F dash is equals to, we can write 2 V by 2 L. Then F dash is equals to 2 F. So now for frequency of the remaining part is how much? Twice that of the fundamental frequency of the open pipe. Twice that of the fundamental frequency of the open pipe. This is one model problem in this. So next. So next example, one open pipe of length L1 and fundamental frequency F1. Next, one closed pipe of length L2 and fundamental frequency F2. If these two pipes are joined, find the fundamental frequency of combined pipe in terms of F1 and F2. Find the fundamental frequency of combined pipe in terms of F1 and F2. So see here, So let us say one is the open pipe of length L1. Open pipe of length L1 and its fundamental frequency F1 can be written as V by 2 L1. So fundamental frequency of the open pipe is V by 2 L1. So another one is closed pipe. Another one is the closed pipe of length L2 and its fundamental frequency is F2 is equals to V by 4. Fundamental frequency of the closed pipe is V by 4 L. Here L is L2, F1. So this is open pipe and this is closed pipe. This is the fundamental frequency and this is the fundamental frequency. Now, second, what is the condition? If these two pipes are joined, how these two pipes are joined and this open pipe is joined with this one? If these two pipes are joined like this, if these two pipes are joined, the resultant pipe is a closed pipe only. If the open pipe and closed pipe are joined together, the resultant pipe is the closed pipe of length L1 plus L2. If these two pipes are joined together, this is L1 and this is L2. If these two are joined together, the resultant is the resultant pipe is the original length of L1 plus L2. L1 plus L2, whose fundamental frequency? Now we have to find out the fundamental frequency of the combined pipe. The combined pipe is acts as, the combined pipe acts as, how it acts as? Closed pipe. Fundamental frequency of the closed pipe is equals to V by 4 into L1 plus L2. Because it is the closed pipe, fundamental frequency of the closed pipe equals to V by 4 L. But what is the L here? L1 plus L2. So from this formula here, from this formula L1 can be written as, but we know F1 is equals to V by 2 L1. From this L1 can be written as V by 2 F1. And F2 can be written as V by 4 L2. So from this L2 can be written as V by 4 F2. Substitute the values of L1 and L2 in this equation. Substitute the values of L1 and L2 in this equation. Then F can be written as V by 4 into L1 can be written as V by 2 F1. So V by 4 F2. So F is equals to V by 4 into V common. So V by 2 common, let us say. So it is 1 by F1 plus 1 by 2 F2. So V by 2 common, it is 1 by F1 plus 1 by 2 F2. So it is 2 2 0. So F is equals to 1 by 2 into VV also gets cancelled. LCM 2F1 F2. So this is 2F2 plus F1. 2F2 plus F1. LCM it is. Therefore, from this F can be written as 2F1 F2 by 2 into 2F2 plus F1. 2 2 gets cancelled. F is equals to F1 F2 by 2F2 plus F1. So that is the frequency of the combined pipe. F is equals to F1 F2 by 2F2 plus F1. So this is one is the open pipe, one is the closed pipe. Their fundamental frequencies are given. That are, those are F1 and F2. Those fundamental frequencies are given. Those are F1 and F2. If these two are combined, the resultant pipe is a closed pipe. Resultant pipe is the closed pipe. So the closed pipe, what is the fundamental frequency of the closed pipe? V by 4 into L1 plus L2, like that. So that is the resultant frequency in this. So next, one more example, let us do. One more example. If third overtone of open pipe is equal to third overtone of open pipe is equal to seventh harmonic of closed pipe. If the third overtone of the open pipe is equal to seventh harmonic of the closed pipe, find the ratio of lengths. Lengths of open and closed pipes like this. How can you do this? See here, third overtone of open pipe. What is the third overtone of the open pipe? So open pipe fundamental frequency V by 2L, first overtone 2V by 2L, second overtone 3V by 2L, third overtone 4V by 2L. So given that third overtone of open pipe is equal to seventh harmonic of closed pipe. So this is the given condition. Third overtone, in the sense we can write 4V by 2L1, length of the open pipe is considered as L1. So that is 4V by 2L1. Third overtone can be written as 4V by 2. Seventh harmonic, that is 7V by 4L2. Seventh harmonic of the closed pipe is 7V by 4L2. So VB gets cancelled. So it is 2Z. So L1 by L2, 8, 2 4s are 8, 8 by 7 is equals to L1 by L2. So ratio of the lengths of the pipes is equals to 8 by 7. So that is the, this is one model problem. So let's do some model problems in this. Let's do some problems based on pipes. So one question it is, an open pipe of 30 centimeters long, an open pipe of 30 centimeters long and a closed pipe of 23 centimeters long. Open pipe is 30 centimeters long. Length of the open pipe is, let us say, 30 centimeters long, and let us say length of the closed pipe is 23 centimeters long. Both are having the same diameter. Both are having the same diameter. That means radius also same. Are each sounding their first overtones are in unison? Are sounding their first overtones are in unison, first overtones. That means, given that first overtone of open pipe is equals to first overtone of closed pipe. First overtone of open pipe is equals to first overtone of closed pipe. So that is the given. Are each sounding their first overtones are in unison. The end correction of these pipes is, we have to calculate the end correction. First overtone of open pipe. First overtone means second harmonic. So 2V by 2 into L plus 2E. L1 plus 2E. Because two end corrections here. Open pipe consists of two end corrections. So that is equals to first overtone of closed pipe. First overtone means third harmonic. So 3V by 4 into L2 plus E. 3V by 4 into 3V by 4L actually. L plus E. So VV gets cancelled, 2 to cancel here. So 4 into L2 plus E is equals to 3 into L1 plus 2E. So 4L2 plus 4E is equals to 3L1 plus 6E. So that is 4L2 minus 3L1 is equals to 6E minus 4E. So 4 into L2. What is the value of L2? 23 minus 3 into 30. So 2E. 4 into 23, how much? 92. 92 minus 90 is equals to 2E. 2 is equals to 2E. E is equals to 1. End correction is 1. So the given condition is lengths of the open pipe and closed pipe are mentioned. And the given condition is both of same diameter are each sounding their first overtones are in unison. First overtones are in unison. That means first overtone of open pipe must be equal to first overtone of closed pipe. Then this is the situation. We have to find out the end correction. Next. So next, let us say, next one more example, one more problem. First overtone of the open pipe has a frequency n. The first overtone of a closed pipe, same length, will have the same frequency. So let us say it is the open pipe of certain length. Its first overtone is n. First overtone is given as n. The first overtone means 2V by 2L. So that is V by L. Next, the first overtone of the closed pipe, and it is the closed pipe having the same length. What is the frequency of the first overtone? First overtone is 3V by 4L. So 3 by 4 into V by L. So 3 by 4 into N.
3 by 4 N. Simple. So next. Next problem. Next problem. An open pipe is suddenly closed at one end.
So let us say it is the open pipe of certain length and it is suddenly closed at one end.
As a result, the frequency of third harmonic of the closed pipe is found to be, frequency of the third harmonic of the closed pipe is found to be higher by 100 hertz than the fundamental frequency of the open pipe. The fundamental frequency of the open pipe is.
So that is the given condition. This is the open pipe of certain length and given that it is suddenly closed and the open pipe is suddenly closed. Due to this closing of this open pipe, given that third harmonic of closed pipe is,
third harmonic or harmonic closed pipe is
higher by 100 hertz than fundamental frequency of open pipe.
Now we have to calculate the fundamental frequency of the open pipe.
This is the given condition. Third harmonic of closed pipe, that is 3V by 4L is equals to, this is higher by 100 plus 100 hertz than fundamental frequency. So that is fundamental frequency of the open pipe is 3V by V by 2L plus 100. That is the given condition. Third harmonic of the closed pipe is 100 hertz higher than the fundamental frequency of the open pipe. Now we have to calculate V by 2L. So first calculate 3V by 4L minus V by 2L is equals to 100, let us say 4L LCM. 3V minus 2V is equals to 100. So that is V by 4L is equals to 100. That is the condition we got. Fundamental frequency of open pipe. Fundamental frequency of open pipe. That we have to calculate. That is equals to V by 2L. So for our convenience, multiply and divide with 2. 2 into V by 2 into 2L. So 2V by 4L. We know the value of V by 4L. How much? 100. So that is 2 into 100. So 200 Hs. That is the fundamental frequency of the open pipe. Based on this given condition, third harmonic of the open pipe, for third harmonic of the closed pipe is 100 Hs higher than fundamental frequency of open pipe. That is the given condition.
Next problem, a metallic wire with tension T and a temperature 30 degrees Celsius vibrates with its fundamental frequency of 1 kHz. The metallic wire with tension T and a temperature 30 degrees Celsius vibrates with its fundamental frequency of 1 kHz. The same wire, the same tension but at 10 degrees Celsius temperature vibrates with the fundamental frequency of 1.001 kHz. The quotient of linear expansion of the wire is.
So we know F is equals to fundamental frequency equals to 1 by 2 L into square root of T by mu. So F can be written as 1 by 2 into square root of T by mu into L square. This L comes under the root. We already discussed about this. T by mu can be written as mass per unit length into L square. So 1 by 2 into square root of T by ml. So from this, frequency inversely proportional to root L. So delta F by F can be written as minus 1 by 2 into delta L by L. So delta F by F is equals to minus 1 by 2 into delta L by L is nothing but alpha delta T. Delta F, F2 minus F1 by F1 into minus 1 by 2 alpha into delta T, in the sense T2 minus T1.
So F2
is given as 1.001 minus 1 divided by 1 minus half alpha into T2 is 10 minus 30. Final temperature is given as 10 and initial temperature is given as 30. 0.001 divided by 1 is equals to minus 1 by 2 into alpha into minus 20. 2 tens are minus of minus. 0.001 equals to 10 alpha. So alpha is equals to 0.001 divided by 10. 0.0001. 1 into 10 to the power of minus 4. degree Celsius. So this is the situation. Next problem. A stretched wire resonates with a given tuning fork, forming standing waves with 5 antinodes between the bridges when a mass of 9 kg is suspended from the wire. When this mass is replaced by the mass M, the wire resonates with the same tuning fork for 3 antinodes for the same positions of the bridges, then the value of M is. So that means the fundamental frequency can be written as generally P by 2 L into square root of T by mu. So F is equals to P by 2 L into square root of mg divided by mu. Here the frequency remains constant, the length remains constant, linear density remains constant. The variables are P root M is equals to constant. So P1 root M1 is equals to P2 root M2. So P1 square M1 is equals to P2 square M2. So P1 square by P2 square is equals to M2 by M1. So number of loops and mass changes here. F equals to P by P is the number of loops or number of segments. Here the quantities, all the quantities, frequency same, linear density same, G same. What are the variables P and M? See the question. Stretched wire resonates with a given tuning fork, forming standing waves with 5 antinodes between the two bridges when the mass of 9 kg is suspended. So that means if M1 is equals to 90, then P1 is equal, number of loops is 5. When the mass is replaced by another mass M, M2 is M, then the string vibrates with 3 antinodes, that means 3 loops. So P1 is 5 square divided by 3 square is equals to M divided by 9 it is. So 9 9 cancel, then M is equals to 25. M is equals to 25 kg. So that is the situation.
ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యారంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్.